a Huey P. Made a martyr out of Martin, out of Malcolm, out of Mega. I refuse to let these dirty devils make Michael a beggar. A hero CEO, I will go Magneto for my people. Give me liberty or death, that is my credo, not my ego. Dressed in a tuxedo, into party alter ego. Killed your leader in gazebo, did it for the people. Love what motivated, I did not do it for hatred. But I truly hate the devil, I cannot debate or fake it. I was asked a question and the asker thought it hard. If I was facing death and I could ask one thing of God, I would ask for every to be free here and abroad. And to be rightfully celebrated as a child of God. And to be rightfully celebrated as a child of God.
Madden Football is the home of the Super Bowl, and this historic matchup is brought to you by EA Sports. It's the Eagles and the Browns coming up next.
It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. We count down to kickoff in what should be an epic one here, as it'll be the AFC champion Cleveland Browns taking on the NFC champions, the Philadelphia Eagles. It has been a tumultuous 2 weeks, but it is finally time for football as we're underway in Super Bowl 62. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
Ready, break!
They'll try and start this drive in the air.
Open man, that's Devontae Smith.
And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. He was a 1,000-yard receiver during the regular season, and that's his first catch of the Super Bowl, and he picks up the first down. Here's the first carry of the game for Cam Akers. And this is going to be an Eagles first down as good running gets him to about the 44.
Well, no slow start here. A couple nice chunk plays back-to-back.
I love the momentum that they're showing here early because they did it both ways, right? Threw the ball on first down for a nice chunk of yardage. Came right back and ran the ball. Looks like they've got the defense set back on their heels. Let's see if they can keep this moving.
On first down, they'll stay with Akers on the ground.
And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 28. Looking to throw. To the left there and complete to the tight end Goddard. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less as they come up on second and inches. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
Here comes the seventh play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's third down.
They'll try and run for this with Akers.
And he is going to have an Eagles first down, at least at first glance, as he'll spot the football just beyond the marker. They find a way to convert on third and inches. On first down, he'll drop to throw. And it's caught. And he's brought down. Now they'll have it first and goal following that gain of 17.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical. They've been crisp. And as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
A chance for the first points of this Super Bowl. It's first and... And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. The sneak successful from a yard out. And the Eagles are on the board first here in this Super Bowl. Elliott good on the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Play action here on first down. He's got Njoku, his big tight end, finding space at the 40. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
This Super Bowl, of course, just a huge one for this head coach. The first time he's walked the sidelines in a game of this magnitude. And you know, I might normally ask the cliche, what's going through his mind right now? But maybe the better question, CD, what do you think are the pitfalls of being a first-time head coach in this game?
Well, you know it's something that he thought about, Brandon, and he had to. And he was thinking about it long before he got to this stage. As the season progressed and he saw that his team was good, if he was smart, he started to make plans right then and there. Reach out to other coaches who have been there before. Find out how they handle winning, losing, handling all the ticket situations, travel, practice, all those things. And then trust your gut, make your best decision, and put it all out there and give your team the best chance to win.
So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 43. Back to throw here.
Man open, that's Anthony Schwartz. And they're going to move it down inside the 25. Give the rookie another one on this opening drive and a first down with it. A nice start, Charles, for the first-year passer. He's come out, made a few plays, nice plays to begin this contest.
He certainly has. And if he finishes off this drive with a touchdown pass, I hope we don't call him rookie anymore. We'll move him right to veteran and continue from there.
And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. That is now 19-yard gains on back-to-back plays.
The opening drive, it continues, Charles, to be all pass, and it's working. Now they're on the doorstep of a touchdown here, first and goal.
Brandon, because it's working so well, I think the entire playbook is open for them right now. Do you want to run it? Do you want to continue to throw it? Spin the dial. Make your choice. But right now,
touchdown, Browns! Nick Chubb, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Browns are an extra point away from tying this Super Bowl at 7. Extra point by York is up and good. And we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
And as the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want to carbon copy what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
You're right about that, partner. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? Just score again, but we know it's not that simple because we don't just make adjustments at halftime if you're a good football team. You spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments to prevent a repeat of the last drive. Series to series, the best teams, that's how they get it done.
And we'll find out here soon enough whether those adjustments are enough defensively.
So that does it for the first quarter of Super Bowl 62. Back in a moment. 7-all is the score. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Open man is Goddard, the tight end. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And that'll be caught. It's St. Brown. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43. So a first and 10 upcoming from Brown's territory now at the 43. They'll look to throw again. He'll go right back to St. Brown.
Touchdown, Philadelphia! Amon-Ra St. Brown, 43 yards, and the Eagles have taken the lead.
Elliott Good with a PAT, and that makes the score 14-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, well,
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about six.
If you're in the offensive huddle, you're smiling after that play because you've certainly got them guessing now. Second and short, could they just hand it off for another big gain? Or did they take advantage of this spot to take a big shot downfield?
And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right in midfield at the 50. That one, a first down pickup of eight.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Now a play fake here on first down. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here on this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. This is the tight end, Njoku. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work this to the 45.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
They'll drop to throw. Over the middle, it's complete. And he has another first down as they get the ball down to the Eagles' 25-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. They give to Chubb out of the gun. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
I don't know what this says about me, but I love successful runs up the middle when the blocking is so well executed like that.
And it doesn't matter whether it's zone blocking.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb. His second touchdown of this Super Bowl.
And the Browns are an extra point away from tying up this Super Bowl.
Extra point by York is up and good. And we are tied at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
And right now, we've got a little bit of an offensive masterpiece going on. Both sides moving the football, scoring points. It's almost like somebody put the defense on rookie mode in this one. I mean, we haven't even left the first half, Charles, and we're certainly on pace for a shootout.
An excellent start for both offenses. The fans have to be enjoying this to see all these points go up on the board. As a former defender, you know I'm not enjoying this at all. But right now, both these teams just trading haymakers. Let's see if anyone slips up first. Can anyone counter with a nice little jab and get things going in their direction?
And the Browns pressure gets to him that time, and he's going to go down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
So this has been a lot like a tennis match, hasn't it? Back and forth. Both these offenses having their way so far. So maybe the question isn't, who's going to score the most points in this game? Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack, finally a first step in the right direction for a stop. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On fourth down, punt coming from Braden Mann. Taken in at the 22. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Browns will take over, first and 10. The Browns drive about to get started. Tie ball game, still a little more than a minute to go in the half. The question, can they put something together here, try to take that lead into intermission?
I would have to think that would be the goal for sure. I don't think you sit on anything here. Here's your opportunity. Push it downfield. As you mentioned, it's a tie game. So minus a disaster on your part, you've got that in your back pocket. Go ahead and try and get some points and feel great going into the half.
The offense schemed, going five wide, trying to create a chance for the big shot, and they took it. If he comes down with that one, that's a huge offensive swing. But credit the defense with a nice play, knocking that one away.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. He finds his man complete. It's Porter. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. Heck of a play there to get to him quickly and get him down for a loss.
I think they did a really nice job getting ready for this game, scouting, watching film, and understanding defensively what the play design was.
We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. Throw left side. There's Schwartz with it. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they get it right at the 30-second mark of this first half. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Back to throw again. Throw left side complete. That's Schwartz. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Right back to him for 10 more and a first.
Time to go.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And that is taken in by Njoku. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward.
He's certainly done a nice job spreading the field on this drive. And here he finds his big tight end for good yardage. And that's what you have to do. Keep defenses guessing about where you're going to go with the football.
York able to send this one through, and they take a 17-14 lead. Well, a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Back to throw. That is caught. It's the tight end Goddard. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Here's Jake Elliott. Career long, by the way, for him, 61 yards. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. So we've reached halftime here in the Super Bowl. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
glad we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. About to get started.
And I think you'd have to say their coaching staff, all things considered, had to be pleased with their performance in the first half of this Super Bowl.
Definitely pleased. Doing their best not to show it to their team, of course, because as you and I both know, their mantra all season long has been finish. Get the job done. They know how close they are to lifting that trophy. One more solid half of football, and they can do exactly that.
He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field.
And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about 5 or 6 plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Out of the gun now on third down. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete.
And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Whenever we talk about moving the sticks and controlling the football, there's a great example right there. Those are the third downs you need to convert to win football games. We're in the third quarter of this one, and this is a tight one. In order to maintain pace, keep the ball away from the other team, and put points on the board, those are the plays they need to continue to convert.
And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. And again, it's Chubb.
And great blocking downfield as he's got this almost to the 35-yard line.
Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Consecutive plays now where that offensive line has really created a lot of space.
And we've seen the confidence rise, haven't we? It borders on arrogance now, and that's that good arrogance, believing you can run the football whenever you get good and ready.
And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
84 yards rushing now for Chubb, and a first down as well.
Well, they're getting ready to go to work now in prime real estate after that last run. Found his spot and picked up nice yardage, didn't he?
And now he's got him knocking on the door of the red zone. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Here we go.
2nd down and 4.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw.